Hi, welcome everyone. I am Dr. Rajkumar. In this video, we'll discuss about random variables and Monte Carlo method. The topics to be covered in this video is random number. There are different types, that is true random number, pseudo random number, Monte Carlo method, and estimation of pi using Monte Carlo method. Now, as the name suggests, random numbers, they are random in nature. They don't have any relation with each other, that is their previous value or the upcoming value. So these numbers that occur in a sequence such that two conditions are met by these numbers. So first one is the values are uniformly distributed over a defined interval or set. And second one is it is impossible to predict future values based on past and present one. So these are the assumptions or prerequisite for random numbers. Now, in earliest times, generating random numbers can be done by throwing a dice, flipping a coin, or by using a roulette wheel. And these are still used today, mainly in games and gambling, as they tend to be slow for most of the application in statistics and cryptography and in computer science. So, random number generators have application in gambling, statistical sampling, computer simulation, cryptography, complete randomized design, and other areas where producing an unpredictable result is desirable. Random number generators are very useful in developing Monte Carlo method and simulations. So, principally, there are two types of random numbers generators. So, first one are some physical phenomena is measured in this category that is expected to be random and then compensate for possible biases in the measurement process. For example, the cosmic background radiation coming from the outer space or radioactive decay of a nuclei as measured over short time scales represent source of natural entropy, because in these events the occurrence of event is random. So this type of random number are called true random numbers, and their generators are called random number generators. The second category, in this category, computational algorithms are used that can produce long sequence of apparently random results, which are in fact completely determined by a shorter initial value, also known as seed value or the key value. As a result, the entire seemingly random sequence can be reproduced if seed value is known. This type of random number generator is often called a pseudo random number generator. So, if you have the key or seed value in case of these pseudo random numbers, then you can reproduce the entire set of random numbers again. Now, pseudo random number generators, which generate numbers that look random but are actually deterministic and can be reproduced if the state of pseudo random number generator is known. Several computational methods for pseudo-random number generation exist, but they mimic true random numbers, but in actual, they are not the true random numbers. All fall short of goal of true randomness, although they may meet with varying success in different areas. Most of the algorithms for generating pseudo-random numbers are recursive in nature. And in general, they may be expressed using this equation. So, xi plus 1 is equal to f of xi, where xi is the number lying in between 0 and 1. So, this equation is a recursive equation which gives you a random number in the range of 0 and 1. Now, the innovation lies in choosing the form of this function f of x. So, you can have a variety of functions for a different set of random numbers lying in between 0 and 1. For uniform distribution of numbers lying in between interval 0 and 1, the function should be such that it should lie on the square of unit length uniformly. Why I am saying square of unit length? Because the random numbers should be equally distributed over the entire range of the square of unit length and uniformly. Now, let us move on to the various characteristics of pseudo random number generators. So, they must be efficient. By efficiency, we means that they can generate large number of or large set of random numbers in a given time. And second is deterministic. So a given sequence of number can be reproduced at a later date if starting point or the seed value in the sequence is known. Determinism is handy if you need to replay the same sequence of number again at later stage. And the third one is periodic. So pseudo-random numbers, since they are using certain function, using certain algorithm, they are producing random numbers. So functions have certain periods. So after a certain given period, they should repeat their random numbers after that time. But nowadays, PRNGs have a period that is so long that it can be ignored for most practical purposes. That is, for a given event or for a given process, they have so many random numbers in a given interval, in a given time, that we don't need the repeated random numbers. Okay, so they are periodic in nature, but in general, this can be ignored. Now let us compare the two random number generators, that is pseudo and the true one. This table summarizes the characteristics of two type of random numbers. Efficiency, determinism, and periodicity, these are the key points which we are comparing for these two number generators. Efficiency of pseudo random numbers are excellent as compared to the true random number, because true random numbers are coming from the experimental events and they are lesser in number. Second one is determinism. So pseudo random number are deterministic in nature if we have initial value or seed value, but true random numbers, they are entirely independent of each other, so they are non-deterministic. Third one is the periodicity, and pseudo random numbers, as we have explained in the previous slide, they are periodic in nature, but their periodicity can be ignored. And true random numbers, they are aperiodic in nature. Now the following table summarizes, for example, which applications are best served by which type of generator. So for example, the applications of lotteries, draws, gambling, games, random number sampling, example drug screening, etc., they are best served using true random number generators. Remember, if you require true random number generator, they are lesser in number, that is efficiency of these generators are less. So if you needed lesser number of random numbers, you can go for a true random number generator. Whereas in simulation and modeling, we need larger, million and million number of random numbers. So pseudo random number generators are best for this purpose. Also in security, example generation of data encryption keys, lesser number of random numbers are required. So two random numbers will be best. And since it is related with the security as well, so completely independent events or random numbers will serve the better for this purpose. And in case of the arts, any art, suitable generator may vary depending upon the art you are using. So you can either use true random number or pseudo random number depending upon your requirement. Random numbers are also generated using humans in the form of collecting various inputs from end users and using them as randomization source. However, most study find that human subject have some degree of non-randomness when attempting to produce a random sequence of example digits or letters. So they may alternate too much between choices when compared to a good random number generator. Thus, this approach is not widely used. Mainly saying that humans have certain biasing with certain numbers, so they are not good random number generators. Now the second topic in this video is Monte Carlo method. The Monte Carlo simulation technique was introduced during the World War II timings. One of the earliest problem which was solved using Monte Carlo technique was to determine volume and masses of cores of nuclear reactor and atomic bombs. And since for calculating volume and masses, you have to solve integrals of higher dimension, so Monte Carlo will serve the purpose very well. Today it is used extensively for modeling uncertain situations. Monte Carlo method or experiments are broadly class of computational algorithm that rely on repeated random sampling to obtain numerical results. The underlying concept is to use randomness to solve problems that might be deterministic in principle. Monte Carlo referred to the use of random numbers to model stochastic, which are statistical in nature, so stochastic or random events that may model a mathematical or physical problem. Typically, Monte Carlo method require many millions of uniformly distributed random numbers. By saying uniformly distributed, it means suppose you need random number in between 0 and 1, and most of your random number lies close to 1. So this type of or this category of random numbers, they are not uniformly distributed because they are concentrated along the number 1 and they are far from the zero. So the number should be uniformly distributed in between 0 and 1. So for that, random variables or inputs are modeled on the basis of probability distributions such as normal, binomial, Gaussian, logarithmic, normal, etc. So you, depending upon your random number distribution, your results may vary. So to understand the underlying concept of Monte Carlo method, let us consider this simple example of finding the area of any irregular shape plane figure. So by saying plane figure, it means it is two-dimensional in nature. So consider this irregular shape. It has two dimensions or two coordinates, x and y. Now enclose this shape within a square of known area. So the idea is, you have any irregular shape, say if it is two-dimensional, you have to enclose this shape in a shape whose area can be easily found. If it is of three-dimensional, you have to enclose it in a cube whose volume can be easily found. So that is why we use to enclose this shape within a square of known area, like this. Now hang on a board this entire square and the regular shape, and ask a blindfolded shooter to shoot at it randomly. Count the number of shots fired, total number of shots. Also count the number of shots lying within this irregular shape. And assuming an unbiasing probability of hitting, we obtain that ratio of area of irregular shape and area of square is equal to ratio of number of shots falling on or within the irregular shape and total number of shots fired. So, alright, so greater is the number of shots, higher is the accuracy of the guess. So you have to increase the number of shots in order to get more accuracy. On a computer, such as probabilistic method can be generated through random numbers. The method of being statistical in nature, we can calculate the statistical measure of error in our computational as well. One such measure of error is called standard deviation. The basic idea is to repeat the measurement many times, keeping the number of shots fired fixed instead of measuring a value once. So whatever we have explained in previous slide, you have to repeat that process number of times, large number of times. Here standard deviation sigma is equal to 1 by square root of n, where n is total number of measurement you made. So greater the number of measurement, more precisely can we locate the true values. Now Monte Carlo method vary, but they tend to follow a particular general pattern given by these four steps. So first one is define a domain of possible inputs. Second one is generate input randomly from a probability distribution over the domain. Then perform a deterministic computation on the method. And fourth one is finally aggregate the results. Now next is find value of pi using Monte Carlo method. So following the procedure explained, we can find the value of pi for an example. Consider a unit square of radius unity, unit circle of radius unity, and close the circle inside a square such that side of square is equal to 2 times radius of circle. So this is a circle of unit radius and enclosed within a square. Okay, so the side of square is 2 times the radius. Now area of circle is equal to pi r square, and area of square is equal to side square. If you take the ratio, we simply find now it is a unit circle, so radius is 1 and side is 2 times 1. So this entire equation reduces to pi by 4. Now ratio of area of circle and area of square is also equal to number of shots falling in the irregular shape divided by and the total number of shots fired, that is n. So m by n, and from above equation we find that m by n is equal to pi by 4 simply, or pi is equal to 4 m by n. Now next is steps of finding values of pi. Let us consider a square of 1 by 4th quadrant only. We have a full square and we are considering only 1 4th of the part. However, the ratio of points is the same, so p is equal to m by n will remain the same. Okay. Now step one is to start a random number generator. Give the number of times shot to be fired, say n. Then initialize the counter m to count the random number lying in within the circle, unit circle. Begin a loop to shoot n times. and also we have to fetch the condition, fetch the random numbers for x and y such that x and y should lie in between 0 and 1. Since we have considered first quadrant only, so here if we take origin at this center and this point becomes r is equal to 1, this is radius, so this point is 1. So we need the random number between 0 and 1 for x axis and random number from 0 to 1 for y axis. Now for checking that whether the number of points lie inside the circle, we have to test through a mathematical equation. So we have x square plus y square less than equal to 1. So x square plus y square is equal to 1 is the equation of circle. If point lies inside the circle, this sum of square of x and y should be less than equal to 1. That is, the pair x and y lies within the quarter circle, and increment the circle, the counter m is equal to m plus 1. So if point lies inside the circle, you have to give the increment to the counter m, that is m is equal to m plus 1. So this first quadrant looks like this when you shot n fires. red dot represents the shots lies inside the circle, and blue dot represents shot lies outside the circle but inside the square. Remember, the scale is in between 0 and 1 for x and y axis. Now the loop started at step 4, now ends here. The loop for beginning a loop to shoot n times, it ends at number 6. So next is to calculate the value of pi. The value of pi we have already derived, that is equal to 4m by n, which is 4 times probability. Probability that shot lies inside the first quadrant of circle. Now possible output of estimate of pi are given in this figure. X-axis shows the number of shots fired, y-axis is estimate for the value of pi, 3.14 is the actual value which is represented by this horizontal line. If you keep on increasing number n, your estimated value will converge to actual value 3.14, so on. So at lower end you have larger error, whereas at higher end error is reduced. So in this video we have discussed about random numbers, true random number, pseudo random number, we have discussed about Monte Carlo method, and we have estimated the value of pi as an example using Monte Carlo method. So thank you for watching this video.